The new Netflix documentary explores the Woodstock concert in 1999 and all of its craziness. So let's see if it's worth your time. Hey everybody, my name is Justin here. I try to watch everything that hits theaters and on streaming services like Netflix. If you guys are like me, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below for more up-and-coming content. Woodstock 99 was supposed to be a millennium-defined celebration of peace, love, and great music. Instead, the festival degenerated into fires, riots, and destruction. I like going to concerts. I've been to a few concerts, but I don't think I'll ever go to something as crazy as Woodstock 99. This is one of the most entertaining documentaries I have seen this year. This is a 3-episode documentary series on Netflix, and it's perfect because you get Friday, you get Saturday, and you get Sunday in one episode. They were really looking forward to doing Woodstock 99, having a really good lineup with Limp Bizkit and Korn, so many other talented musicians. It seemed like it was going to be something epic, but the quick little snippets of what was to come promised something absolutely crazy. Besides the absolute chaos and the destruction of it all, it seemed like a good time. I was just going to say that. I feel like if I went to Woodstock 99, I would have the time of my life. But what this series explores is the downfall of this concert and how everybody was setting it up. You have interviews with different staff members, security guards, people who attended the show, journalists as well, so many different people that are being interviewed for it. But Friday, the first episode establishes setting up the concert and building the venue and inviting people and having all of the fans come and people really excited for it. A lot of people were there. And then the destruction, tearing down certain towers, certain musicians just egging on everybody. It was absolutely crazy. I love that progression from that first episode to that third episode. Everybody seemed like they were having a good time and everything was just going to be fun and enjoyable. And then it just started to become really crazy. But they don't explore, you know, what happened. Why was it so crazy? They also explored how the setup for Woodstock 99 was also a failure and how they were charging like $4 for a bottle of water, which now is fine, I guess, for like sporting events and concerts. That's an average price for a bottle of water. But in 1999, that was crazy. People were mad that they had to pay $4 for water. And then they wanted to have pay-per-view as well. There's a lot of things that made it seem like they were greedy about the concert instead of just having this big epic concert. So not only do we focus on the fans going crazy, but also the greed behind this concert and what led to its failure and the setup and just the location. There were people that were trying to warn others about the concert and the lineup and everybody that was coming. They felt like it was going to be a disaster, and it eventually was. The second episode is when we really start to pick up and it just becomes chaos with a couple musicians and people just going absolutely insane for Korn and Limp Bizkit and the wave of everybody, the 400,000 people. It's insane to see the actual footage of it. When you have documentaries, they have to use art or reenactments to cover up certain interviews. You get footage from everything, the fans, the setup, the concert itself, and then you just feel like you're absolutely there with that concert and it just falling apart. And then that third episode, no one cares what's going on. People just felt like they couldn't get in trouble for things. They're tearing down towers, they're destroying things, starting fires, people are getting hurt left and right. It's like that movie Project X, about that party that just goes absolutely insane and just terrorizes the house. That's what that is, but it actually happened. So we have that nice Friday set up, people enjoying the music. Saturday's getting a little crazy, people are concerned. And then Sunday, I don't know, no one cares anymore, just destroying things left and right. But I like that they actually had interviews with people who were there. Security guards, musicians, everybody was being interviewed. And I just gives a really personal perspective to what had happened. And some people thought it was fun and they enjoyed it. And when they reminisce about Woodstock 99, they have some fond memories. Other people, on the other hand, just were angry with what had happened. So you kind of get that balance of people really enjoyed it, and they enjoyed the music, and they love listening to people like Korn. Then you got the other side, the people who were angry with musicians like Korn and how they riled up the crowd, and it just went insane. But I gotta say, I had a good time with this. I felt the energy. When I go to the club or go to a concert, I feed off of energy. If the energy is great, if there's great music, I'm gonna have a good time. And I feel like if I was there, I would have a great time. Despite destroying things and hurting people and going absolutely insane, this seemed like it was a good time. And you got that vibe within this series. But also interesting to look at the downfall and how poorly it was set up as well. So you got a nice balance of everything, and it's one of the best documentaries I have seen this year. So before I give you my score for Trainwreck Woodstock 99, make sure to check out my channel. Here I do movie reviews, trailer actions, ranking videos, tier lists, all that fun movie related content that you see on YouTube. I do it all here, so hit that subscribe button and get it all in one spot. I'm gonna go ahead and give Trainwreck Woodstock 99 a B+. Thank you guys for checking my review for Trainwreck Woodstock 99. Have you guys seen it by chance? What did you think about this new documentary series? Let me know in the comment section down below and stay tuned for more up and coming content like this. My name is Justin Watches Movies, and you guys stay classy, YouTube.